When I started working for the zoo about 30 years ago, there hadn't been a lot of hormone studies being done in wildlife. I found out there was virtually nothing known about the biology of elephants.
You've known me for 30 years. I've known you about as long as I've known most of the people in my work.
Longer.
It's very difficult to ask an animal, you know, are you happy? Do you have good welfare? Because there are very few ways of looking at that. The work we do in the endocrine lab is we've developed a number of assays to monitor things from reproduction to health, looking at some hormones that are actually considered happiness hormones, like oxytocin, so that we can study all aspects of an animal's life. It's important that we keep a close eye on them. Any biologist would love to know that all elephants were free-ranging in the wild. But the fact is, their habitats are being destroyed. Humans are encroaching into their territory. There's a lot of human-elephant conflict. So our captive populations are turning out to be a very important insurance population. There are fewer and fewer elephants in the wild, and so if we don't have a healthy, sustaining population under human care, those countries are not going to have any elephants at all. I started going over to Asia and realized that the captive elephant populations over there also were not breeding very well. We established an endocrine lab at the Chiang Mai University, and they've started doing the same thing that we're doing. Now we have a fair population explosion on some of those camps over there that are actually using our tools. I am optimistic that we're going to figure out what needs to be done for elephants. The governments now are really starting to pay attention to the problems that are facing their native species. So I'm seeing a lot of movement in a positive direction. And I think we're going to be at the forefront so that when the opportunity does come to start reestablishing populations, we're going to know a lot better how to do it.